Hello, my name is Doug Hubble, and welcome to Astrophotography Tutorials. Today I'm going to talk about planetary imaging. Planetary imaging is very easy to do, and it's an inexpensive hobby to get started. The only drawback with planetary imaging is that you're limited to a very few targets. You'll be able to do the Moon, you'll be able to do Saturn and Jupiter. And Mars, well, you might be able to make out a little bit of detail, but it's basically an orange star, so there really isn't much you can see beyond those three targets. But the one thing is, any video camera will work. Today I'm going to go through a few different video cameras. Here's just a video camera. Here's a Funai. That's one that you could use for planetary imaging. You could even use any smartphone that has a camera on it. You could use that to do planetary imaging. I have another camera right here. A lot of places make dedicated solar system imaging cameras. This particular one is called Neximage, and it's from Celestron. And one movement that's really popular with a lot of people is taking webcams and modifying them to make solar system imaging cameras. So it doesn't really matter which video camera you use, you could use most anything. And once you get your video camera that you would like, you have to next figure out how to put it on the telescope. This is what I'm going to use for my demonstration purpose. If you decide to use a Coronado PST telescope, the one thing that you'll need to do is you'll need to get a 2X Barlow. There's all types of Barlows. You could probably use most any one you'd like. Why you have to use it on the PST, and it's only on the PST, is because it doesn't have enough focal length in the focus knob back here. It's not like your standard telescope that has like a Crayford focuser that goes in and out. So you need this 2X Barlow on there to begin your imaging of the sun. And here I have right here is a SPC 900 Philips webcam. And what I did is I purchased this little 1.25 adapter nozzle to go on the end of it. And what this little nozzle does is it allows you to modify the camera where you can put it on there, and then it will be able to just connect to your telescope very easily like this. Now here's another type of solar system imager. This is a Neximage video camera. Basically Celestron and Orion both, they make these solar system imaging cameras. It has the advantage that it already has the 1.25 nozzle on it, so you don't have to do any hunting, you don't have to do any modifications to any kind of a web camera. So if you're not a do-it-yourself kind of a person and you'd rather just buy a camera already made, you can pick these up. They're relatively inexpensive. I think you can pick them up for about $100, right in that area. And it does the same thing. Like if you're going to use a Coronado PST, you're going to have to use a Barlow and put it on there to then put it onto the telescope like that. But very easy. Just put it on. If you're using a regular telescope, you wouldn't have to use the Barlow. You would just put it right directly to your telescope. If you're using an eyepiece, you just take the eyepiece and you put it on the end of your telescope. And what you do then is you can take whatever video camera you have and put it above the eyepiece and take pictures of it. Now, I've seen people do this. You know, they'll hold their smartphones or their iPhones, whatever camera they have, above the eyepiece, and you get kind of mixed results. I mean, you're not going to get a very steady image because your hand cannot keep it still there. So what a better option would be is to actually have your camera held steady over the eyepiece if you decide to use this option. If you take a look around, Orion has this one called a Steady Pick. You just take your smartphone, it's universal. You can just hook it up to your eyepiece and you can use your smartphone like that. One of the things that I'm going to show you today is there's this SteadyPix camera mount, and I'll show you how to use that. I've got one of those here, and I'll show you how to use that and put that on next. The camera is just right above the eyepiece here. Might have to do a little bit of maneuvering around to get it, but once you get it there, you can kind of see that it just is held right above the eyepiece, and it's very easy to do once you get it. Well, there you have it. As you can see, most any video camera will work for planetary imaging. You can buy one that's dedicated by Celestron or Orion, or you could get a web camera and modify it so you can put it on your telescope, or you can buy a bracket and then use this bracket to put your video camera on top of your telescope. The main important idea here is you need to hold your camera steady on top of your video camera steady on top of your telescope. I wouldn't recommend using your phone and just kind of like holding it over there. You won't get the results that you really need to achieve. Stay tuned for my next video where we'll go outside and we'll discuss how to capture the image. Everything. Thanks for watching. We'll see you later. Bye.